Okay, now in part B, you'll see we write a transfer function. We'll here 0, that is z is nothing but 0, p is nothing but poles is given for a transfer function. So here z is nothing, no 0, so it is written blank. So p number, p, there are two poles, that is complex poles -10 plus 30i, -10 minus 30i, two poles is given for the first case. K gain is 1000 is given. System, we need to plot ZPK, all taking all three. So time is given, step response of system and grid. This is the transfer function we written. So now in this case, we need to check what is the, when we add any extra pool to the system, what the response. So before that, we'll check what is the response of this system. We're not adding any. So for this, we need to check what is the response of this system. So I written program here. So as per this, I written, I not added anything. Two poles are there. Zeros are zero, no zeros. K is given. So I'll execute this. So we'll get this waveform. So in this case, note on the reading of all this, what is the peak response? What is settling time? What is rise time? Is it not? So copy this before adding any to the system, any extra pole to the system. So this is original system, what we are getting values. So now if we add pole to the system, what happens, we'll see. See now, it is a program we need to enter. So here I'll enter -1 pole. If I shift pole toward -1, what happens? It is, now it is at the origin, now at -10. I'll add one more -1 to the pole. So what happens? I'm adding -1 towards left hand side. Then what is the system response? Then we need to check. So save it. And in the tabular column, they have given, see, location of poles -1. So this is, so first case, we have not added anything. I will not know the values before changing. So now location of pole is -1. Then what is the effect on time response? Then we need to calculate. We should know what are the values of time, peak, rise time, all those things. See, program changed. I put -1, is it pole location, -1 here I added. So I execute this, run the program. So we'll get graph. So you're getting graph like this. So this is not complete. So in the program, time you need to change, make it is only up to 10. So we'll get again run. So we'll get the graph like this. See, when you change the system pole, it comes, this is the when you change pole location in a transfer function as S plane towards the negative infinity, this is the effect. So again, calculate peak response. Okay, what is the peak response and what is its settling time? So we need to calculate what is the effect on the system when you change towards minus, is it not, towards -1, all those things. So see, this is, these values you got for at -1. Similarly, if you change to 100 or 10, 10 second is 10, is it not? Again, save it and execute. So what is the thing? What, how do you get? See, this transfer function would like, you'll get like this. Again, you measure peak response, settling time, rise time. So note down all those things. So you can compare the values before shifting the pole towards negative infinity, what are the values and what effect on the transfer. We can give the conclusion on that. So note down these values and compare before and after. So before shifting to -1 to -10, what are the values and compare. And then when you are shifting the pole towards negative infinity, what are the effect on the system, you can give the conclusion. So this is about pole shifting. Now we'll see, zero shifting. Zeros, if you shift towards negative infinity, what happens?